This budgeting method is going to change your life. I am not kidding. And today we are going to show you exactly how to do it.
Hey guys, it's Joseph.
And Tasha with One Big Happy Life.
We make videos about how to find balance, build wealth, and live happy. So if that sounds amazing and you want more of those videos, this is a place to be. Subscribe and click the bell for notifications.
So today we are going to be showing you exactly how to budget for a whole year at a time. We are going to be walking you through step by step, making it in front of you. Now, if you've never heard of budgeting for a whole year at a time, we've got two videos down below for you to check out. Our 2019 budget, which shows our yearly budget, and the video we did on how to budget for a full year at once.
That video gives you a deep dive into a year-long budget, so it's a great place to start. Also, if you head over to our website, onebighappylife.com/budget, you can get a free budget template.
So this video is actually part of our Change Your Life series, which we started back in November with 10 ways to change your life in 2018. Those same ways still apply in 2019, and having a year-long budget was one of the things on the list. So we're going to be doing more videos, of course, aimed at helping you live your happy, change your life. But today we're going to start with budgeting because money is so important. So let's look at this year-long budget.
The first step to creating a budget is to calculate your monthly income. So for us, we get paid every other week, and so we have four paychecks in a month, and then we have those two extra paychecks. So let's start with a regular pay. It's $11,500 for the entire year. And our extra paychecks land in May and October, $5,650. And then, of course, we have our side business, OBH.
Which the minimum amount that we typically, at this point, we expect to receive after taxes and expenses would be $2,000 a month. So I'm going to just spread that across. So when we were initially making our budget, that's what we would do. But then we'll get contracts that will bump up how much revenue we expect to receive in any given month. So then we'll change it. So let's do that.
And so January and February, we expect $10,000. Mm-hmm. And then March, April, and May, $3,000. And then we'll get our total income for each month.
Alrighty, there that is. So now we're going to skip over savings and head over to expenses. So that would be all of our monthly expenditures. And we recommend going with just the required expenses at first, when you're first making your budget. And then you can tweak it once you see what your surplus looks like.
For car, we have insurance, maintenance, and gas. Our insurance is $105, maintenance $100, and gas $150. We like to organize our expenses into three major categories: car, household, and lifestyle. So it's a lot easier to understand when you look at the budget.
So let's look at the car section. You can see that we have insurance, maintenance, and gas. So insurance and gas are pretty much fixed. That's what we tend to spend every single month on those two categories. Now maintenance, the way that we calculate that, because those are irregular expenses, is we figure how much we're going to spend on car maintenance throughout the year. So we'll include things like replacing tires, replacing brakes, because that doesn't happen every year, but it happens every few years. So we'll factor that a yearly cost for those expenses. And then things like
oil changes and air filters, we know that that's going to happen much more frequently. And so we go ahead and throw that in with a little bit extra for those unexpected repairs.
So then you just add all of that up and divide by 12, and then you just make sure you're putting that into a sinking fund. So then the next time you need something done to your car, the money is just already there waiting. So now let's go into household, which is basically everything related to our house.
And of course, these are the minimums at first. Mortgage is $3,215. Electricity and gas, $250. Water and trash, $50. Alarm, $30. Internet, $75. Cell phones, $80. And we also have a home decor line item, but we're not going to fill that in right now.
All right, next up is the lifestyle stuff. Now, some of these are mandatory, like...
Okay,
Someone is at the front door.
Okay, so some of these are mandatory, like groceries and preschool, because we have to pay Reeve's preschool tuition, and some of these are optional, like clothing, Netflix, and fun monies. So we are just going to put in the mandatory things.
Groceries are $1,000, health insurance $450, and preschool $1,000.
So the next thing we're going to do is move down to debt. Now, I've already populated our total debt balances, which are right here for our consumer debts. So I'm just going to plug in the minimum payment.
The 401k is $120. The roof is $385. The AC is $225. The car is $370. And my student loans are $550.
So that shows us that at least for January, we would have a budget surplus of $4,300 and, oops, that's not right. I put $10,000 for preschool instead of $1,000. I'm like, that seems low. $13,345 would be our budget surplus for January. So what I'm gonna do is just drag all of these numbers across just to show you how quick and easy it is to then create a year-long budget. There's that.
And so now this is the point where you look at what is hopefully a budget surplus, but if it's not a budget surplus, you have a negative number, then that's a red flag that you need to go back and make sure you got all your income, and then see if you added any extra expenses that you don't actually need to have there. And if you still don't have a budget surplus and you're in the red, you clearly have to make some changes, because that is a great concern, because you're going to be funding your minimum expenses with debt. Mm-hmm. And you don't want to be doing that.
Okay, so you can see our budget surplus down across the bottom. The green doesn't mean anything. It's just a total line. So even if we were negative, it would still be black. So I'm just going to take it negative here in January by making daycare $20,000. You see it now, it goes down to negative $5,655. So this is where the power of an annual budget really comes in, because so now we have kind of our bare minimum expenses. Now the groceries are not bare minimum. That is our very comfortable grocery budget. We can go much, much lower than that. We can almost cut that in half just easily. But right now, it's just the comfortable number. So if you look at the budget surplus, I also have a sum here at the end of all of the year's worth of budget surpluses. We have this $94,000 surplus. So if we followed our budget exactly, that's how much money we would have left over. But we do have goals that we want to reach, and there are some lifestyle things that we want to add to our budget because we know that we have the surplus. So we're going to revisit the lifestyle section and add in a couple of things right now.
Okay, so we're going to add in clothing, $200, Netflix plus some other subscriptions, $40, our fun money is $200, and gifts, $100 for January.
Okay, so I'm just gonna copy all of those across, and then we'll see if we tweak those numbers as the year goes on, because we're going to assess our year month by month right now, starting with our next major goal, which would be paying off debt. So let's look at that.
So in January, we want to hit debt hard and pay off the roof, $9,000. So Tasha's going to delete all those other minimum payments through the rest of the year because we don't need them. Next, we have a lot of remainder left. So we're going to continue to pay off debts. Our AC, $4,000. And Tasha's going to delete those minimum payments too.
Okay, at this point now, we're looking at it, and it's like, well, there's still $415 left over. And I could say, like, I really want to have a home decor budget, and I'm comfortable adding a little bit of that in. Like, I want to use some of that money for home decor. I can always take it out later as we're going through our other financial goals if we find that it's too tight. So, okay, so I think we're ready to move on to the next month. So now we're in February. We're still working on paying off debts. So what are we paying off now?
We're going to pay off the car, $6,500.
And then we'll put another $7,000 towards the 401k loan so that we know the next month we need to pay just 4,000. And so then that takes care of all of our debts, except for Joseph's student loans. And so at that point now, we've knocked out the debt payoff goal that we had within the first 3 months of the year, and we're ready to move on to our savings goals for the year. So I'm going to scroll up. We can't actually see both. So I'll have to scroll back and forth on this. Maybe I'll make it smaller. Sorry if you guys are going to have a hard time seeing this. I'm going to continue to make it smaller so we can, yeah, there we go. So squint, pinch, like zoom in on this. So, oh, something else that we need to do, travel, right? There are other some.
Oh, there is.
So we need to tweak this. It's not quite right.
You're right.
Oh, we forgot my bonus.
Oh.
Yeah. So I'm just gonna, that's, yep, there we go. So the next thing we need to add in is that we are going on vacation in March, but it was important to us that we pay off our debt first. That's the priority. So now we're going to put aside the money that we know we're gonna need for that trip under the vacations. So we're doing 1,000 in February and then 2,000 in March.
We're also gonna go ahead and bump up the gift budget for February and March because Alexis and Reeves have their birthdays.
Now that we've added some of those other things in, we're just gonna tweak. It's like playing with it and tweaking it to make it be exactly what you want it to be. So I think we're just going to throw up an extra $1,000 in savings in February, just because it'd be nice to have a little extra cushion. So now our other goals for the year, we want to build up $18,000 in our emergency fund, save $24,000 for Alexis's college education, and then also save money for a car. So we are going to work on all three of those at the same time.
By car, she means truck.
So we have $6,000 left over in April, so we can do $2,000, $2,000, $2,000. That says 200, but I meant 2,000. And then I'm just gonna, so then May is an extra paycheck month. So we can actually make some substantial progress on all these things in May. We have a $12,000 surplus here. So let's do 4,000, 4,000, 4,000. And then the next 4 months, we have a $5,000 surplus. So what's 5,000 divided by 3, Joseph? 1,500-ish?
Yeah. Maybe
1,500. Okay, and I'm just gonna copy that over. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I think it should be good enough for the rest of the year. And then we can add more things in. So our savings is almost there. We've almost hit that goal. So I'm gonna add in an extra 500 here.
Yeah,
so actually, I don't need to scroll. I can just do that.
Yeah, I see. Yeah, so then we hit the savings for an emergency fund.
And now we need to just finish up Alexis's. So I can see just looking right across the bottom here that we have at least $1,000 left over a month. So I'm gonna bump up her college savings to $2,500 a month and see how close that gets us to our $24,000 goal. There we're at $22,500, so we're almost there. And then we can see we have our second extra paycheck here in October. So we're just gonna add that in. We need another $1,500 to get where she needs to go there. Bam, $24,000 in Alexis's fund. And then we have $16,500 in a car fund and $18,000 in our savings fund. So we hit all of our goals there. Yes, and so you can see there's still some flexibility because we have some remainder still down here at the bottom. We didn't go straight to zero. We could, but we didn't, because this is just creating a budget and a plan for the year. Things will tweak and change throughout the year. Like, for example, we're going to show you right now a real life change. So Alexis got her driver's license a couple of weeks ago. We put her on our insurance as a driver because before she just had a permit, and it doubled our insurance.
Yeah.
So he here's what that would... So here's what that would look like. It's now $200 a month. So I'm gonna just adjust that.
And then we'll see what impact that has on the remainder at the bottom.
And so,
some of those on a couple of months are a little bit skimpy.
Yeah.
And we recommend having some remainder every month so that an unexpected expense or fluctuation isn't going to just completely kill your budget. And so a $10 remainder, that's not enough for us.
Yeah.
I mean, and that's a trip to Starbucks away from a problem.
Yeah. So you can see that we do still have, we carry an overall surplus for the year for $69.30. So that is how you would create a year-long budget and then you tweak as you go. Now, that's a lot of information in a single video. This video is probably gonna be super long. So watch it a couple of times, drop us questions that you have down below, and we'll make sure to incorporate them in a future video.
All right, we'll see you guys next time.
Bye.
Bye.